We're here with head coach Renee Lawrence-Gillespie following the UCF's 5-1 win over Bethune-Cookman. And coach, the offense got going. Four runs in that third inning really broke the game open, and Allie Schmidt took it from there.
It was a good inning for us. We led up the game well. Natalie starting off with a base hit to start the first inning, and we thought we were going to get kind of rolling in the first part of it. Slowed down, they came back and tied us up in the second inning, and it was good fourth inning to be able to see the bats come alive.
And it's a good win on a Wednesday. You're coming in mid-between conference games. These games are, Bethune is playing very well coming in, has 6-0 in the MEAC. Alabama lost to Georgia State yesterday, so these games are tough, and yet your team, again, a young team, showed focus and very confident, very mature for a young team.
They were. We made a few mistakes, a couple of errors that we would have been a little bit more aggressive. We wanted to be a little more aggressive on. We kind of set back on a couple ground balls that we should have been tough on. Always looking for ways to improve, as you can tell, but they did well. I mean, having a midweek game, coming off a long road stretch last weekend at UAB, and finally having 2 weeks at home is going to help us out. But we needed this midweek game to get us ready for this weekend with Memphis.
Let's talk about Allie. Another solid outing for her. She's now 10 wins on the year, kind of under the radar in the shadow of McKenzie, but really having a great year, top five ERA in Conference USA, and could make a case for newcomer of the year in the conference, and maybe some consideration for maybe first or second team all conference.
Well, that's what we're hoping. I mean, she's got the numbers to be able to get up there, and like you said, it's tough to be behind Mac, and seeing all the accolades that Mac has had over the years. You know, she's pitcher of the week again this week, and third time for this year, and has just done some great things for us to get exposure back in our program and helping us out. And Allie, she just gets it done when she gets out there. She's very determined. You can see it on her face when she throws. And this was a good game for her to kind of get that win under her belt and feel good about going in this weekend.
Mentioned McKenzie. She won pitcher of the week for Conference USA second week in a row. That's three times this year. Only Allison Kine back in 07 and 08 has done that in UCF in the Conference USA era. Also, McKenzie now featured in an interview by Graham Hayes on ESPN.com. Nationally, people can check it out right now on the websites. Go to the More Sports softball page. I mean, she's getting a lot of national attention. She's seventh in the country in ERA. Just a phenomenal achievement for a freshman, which obviously you got to be very proud of her. But did you imagine this when you even recruited her, that she'd be this good this fast?
Yeah, well, we knew recruiting her that she had the tools. Very determined pitcher, had the tools that we needed as far as her spins. Again, we talk a lot about Casey Clark and the kids that she works with, and Mac was one of those kids that she's been working with over the years to help her understand the intensity that she needs, the focus she needs to be a good pitch at this level. Never expected her to come in and do what she's doing as a freshman. We expected this out of her by sophomore, junior year, but to see her coming out and just really taking charge her freshman year is a wonderful thing.
And giving you some national attention, ESPN, give us some of the touches. Always good for the program, always to get exposure nationally.
It is. I mean, she's put us on the map, being able to throw against Washington, UCLA, going against Florida State and having that game won, and we lost in the seventh inning, but going against Florida and winning that game, finally, just each game she's improving, each game she's getting tougher and tougher, and each game she's acting like a Division I top pitcher. She should be getting that recognition that she's getting now, because she's what you look for as a coach. She's getting out there, she's winning games, she's helping to stay in games that we need, the close games that we need to stay into, and give us a chance to get our offense going, and that's what it's all about. She's coming out and working for the team, and she does that every time she pitches.
Well, she'll go up against Memphis this weekend. You go back to conference play. Memphis playing a lot better. They swept UTEP last weekend, almost beat Tennessee last night, a 3-2 ball game there. They're playing much better after a rough start to the year. It's going to be another battle. Conference games, every game matters, and it will be no different this weekend.
Yeah, you can't take anyone lightly in Conference USA. It's crazy going into the last three weekend series with Memphis, Marshall, and Houston, and every one of those games, like you talk about, it's gonna make a difference on where we stand in the regular season. We're still in the running to be able to win the conference, but we got to take care of business, and we got to take care of the last nine games in our conference series. And even with that, it's given us a good setting for the UAB, the conference tournament that's going to be at UAB. We've got on that field last week, which was great. We got a chance to play on that field we'll be playing on for the conference tournament. We get a feel for what we need to do to be able to play on that field. We had an interesting weekend there, so we're ready for that. But then, being able to come out and have this game and kind of prepare us going into Memphis and just focusing on this weekend and making sure that we're taking care of business as we go through the next nine games.
Well, Coach, congrats. 32nd win of the season. We'll see you this weekend against Memphis.
Thank you, Eric.
Head Coach Renee Lawrence-Gillespie following UCF's 5-1 win over Bethune-Cookman.